Hello everyone. Today we are going to read about electrical energy conservation, which is a very important aspect or very important topic. And in the previous class we have studied about the calculation of different lighting parameters, and today a very interesting topic we are going to study, which is electrical energy conservation. Because the basic importance, why actually we are studying this electrical energy conservation and auditing, why, what is the necessity being a mechanical, not only for the triple E branch or electrical branch, but now it is equally important to every aspect, all different branches of engineering. Clear? And irrespective of branch, this particular course is going to play a massive important role in your life, because this particular course, that is electrical energy conservation and auditing, has been introduced mainly as a part of you can say NP 2020 program, that is, or NEP, National Education Policy 2020. So the main usage is to save the energy for your future generation, or for the future generation, being the children. So your future generation, coming generation, they should, at least they should not face a problem regarding this particular energy conservation, or maybe some scarcity of electrical energy. Clear? And there are many different ways where you can reduce your where you can save energy. That is what today, in today's class, we are going to see. Clear? Electrical energy conservation, this is very, very important topic, and this is, you can say, you can take it as a generalized topic, where these 10 ways, these 10 ways or 10 procedures where we can save energy, we can also try to put it in our own day-to-day life. So let us see what are the different 10 ways to save the energy. Clear? So here the different 10 ways to save the energy is, there are many different ways to reduce your household energy use. So in our day-to-day life, in our household, we are using this electrical energy, and we can adjust ourselves, or we can reduce that particular usage of electrical energy by doing some kind of adjustments in our day-to-day life, or how we live our life in that particular what you can say, the way of we living the life, that we can change it to a little bit extend, or the behavior, some adjustments you can do. So the major motive for conserving this particular electrical energy or energy is to save our utility bills, and also the other aspect is to protect the environment. That is, these are the two aspects. So, but basically we are concentrating on 10 most common ways, and out of these 10 most common ways to conserve energy, most of the ways we know it how to do, but most of the people, we are not doing it. Clear? And we are not saving electricity in our home. Clear? And below the 10 ways to save energy, they are the simple and most intensive methods which we can do it in our day-to-day life. We can put it, or we can put it as a kind of a activity which we have to do in our day-to-day life, subject to conserve this electrical energy. That is our main motto for future generation. So to save the energy for future generation, that is what I want to say. So the first way to save energy is to adjust your day-to-day behavior. Adjusting day-to-day behavior means the whatever the energy consumption that is taking place in your home, it is not at all necessary that you go out and purchase those electrical equipments which are energy efficient. That is not the motto. The main That means buying those electrical equipments which are highly star rated or highly energy efficient electrical equipment. That is not our motto. That anybody can do it. But energy conservation can be much more simple. A very simple technique is, if you are switch off the lights or those electrical appliances when you are not needing them or when you are not at all using them, you can switch off the lights and you can switch off those appliances, electrical appliances, fan, many electrical appliances nowadays you find in your home. Whenever you don't need them, better you switch it off. Okay, so better is, besides this, you can also have energy intensive appliances. That means energy saving appliances, higher star rated appliances also you can have it in your house. Okay, so ultimately what you do is, better than that, whenever possible you try to do the household tasks manually, like drying your clothes. Okay, dry your clothes in sunlight instead of using this particular putting them your clothes in the dryer, or washing dishes by hand instead of using this dishwasher machine. Okay, so there are certain things where you can do it manually and you can save this electrical energy instead of using these intensive appliances which nowadays you find where technology is going on improving day by day. This kind of adjustments in your behavior, ultimately what will happen is, it will try to bring the consumption of energy, electrical energy basically, into a the consumption will become very less. Ultimately what will happen, the utility bills also will become less. So ultimately the we can save money, we can save energy, we can save everything. So these are some of the tools where you can figure out where most of the electricity is actually getting wasted in your home, or in which area actually electricity waste is, or most of the money is getting consumed in the form of electrical energy, that you can find it out. Mostly in winter you'll find we are using these room heaters, and mostly in summers these air conditioners we are using it. So this particular, mostly you'll see half of your during this winter and summer season, clear, half of your average, more than half, or you can say nearly half of that particular current bill or the utility bills, half of it is due to this particular, in winter season it is due to the room heater, and during summer season it is due to the air conditioner. You see it? Yeah, so that you have to figure it out. So in your home, in your day-to-day basis, which particular electrical appliances are actually using or consuming most electricity, that you can find it out. Okay. The second thing is, replace your light bulbs. That is again one more important thing, which most of us, we do it. Now, the earlier we were using traditional incandescent lights. Nowadays also you'll find this 100 watt bulbs, incandescent bulbs, 100 watt bulbs, these halogen bulbs. They consume very excess amount of electricity, and they should be actually replaced by other energy efficient bulbs. We have different alternatives also. Clear? We have CFL bulbs, halogen incandescent bulbs are there, LED bulbs, light emitting diode bulbs. Okay. So by this, if you use this, 25 to 80% of less electricity gets consumed, and the lifetime or the longevity of those bulbs, halogen and CFL and LED bulbs, the longevity is also 3 to 25 times better than traditional bulbs. Okay, so, but no doubt, when we talk about the cost aspect, the energy efficient bulbs are much more expensive. But when we try to compare our when we try to calculate their efficiency and long lasting, longevity, all these things, if we think about long run, this particular cost is look like very less cost. Okay. The third thing is, the third way where you can save this electrical energy, electrical conservation, where you can do it, electrical energy conservation you can do, the third way is, okay, to save energy is using smart power strips. So let us see what is this actually smart power strips. You can see here this. This is what I'm talking about. Where you can save energy in your household with this particular smart power strip. You can see this here. Now these I'm talking about this. This is called as smart power strip. Okay, you can see. Now, what actually is this smart power strip? Now, this actually which you're seeing in the screen, it is actually advanced power strip where you can easily save money. And it is very good equipment and very energy efficient equipment. Clear? So you may ask yourself, sir, what is the necessity of and why should I necessity of using or buying this power strip when ultimately I'm going to switch off all the lights? See, the reason behind why you are using this particular power strip is, I'm going to say you, is in this particular, if you use this smart power strip, you might have heard about this phantom load. Phantom loads means there are some, what you can say, electrical equipments, or phantom loads are those loads where electricity is used by those equipment even if they are turned off also, or even if they are in standby mode also. So that is nothing but it is an energy waste. Now, in fact, it has been seen that 75% of the energy used in household electronics is consumed when they are switched off, when they are in switched off conditions. So those kinds of loads are called as phantom loads, where in switched off conditions also, if you switch off also, it is consuming power. So it actually, when we talk about 75% of energy annually per year, so it's coming around the 20,000 rupees per year. It is a wastage of money. So you can use these smart power strips, which is also known as advanced power strips, where you can eliminate this particular problem of phantom loads. Okay, so how you can do it? You can eliminate these phantom loads simply by shutting off the power to electronics when they are not in use. So smart power strips, they can be set to turn off at an assigned time during a period of inactivity. Clear? So through remote switches or based on the status of master device, using remote or using maybe which type of switch condition also, that also you can use. So this particular elimination of this phantom loads, you can do it, or you can, by using the smart power strips, you can eliminate this, where you can save energy, money also. Next way to conserve energy, okay, to conserve this particular electrical energy conservation, the fourth way is to install a programmable or smart thermostat. What is a programmable thermostat? So programmable thermostat means you can actually automatically this will turn off, or thermostat, we are talking about this heaters, water heaters in bathrooms. So if you have programmable thermostat automatically turning off, turning on, reducing heating and cooling during the times, and this particular programmable thermostat you can use in the concept of this ACs also. You have nowadays in almost all the ACs, you have this sleep button in your AC remote. Clear? Where actually nowadays ACs have come where, depending upon the number of persons, it gets the temperature of that particular AC gets reduced or gets increased. So these are all programmable. Clear? So when you feel, when you sleep, then that particular thermostat which is there inside the air conditioner, it will become switch off when the room temperature is actually if you fix the room temperature to 24, clear. That means when it reaches 24, the room temperature reaches 24 degree, the AC gets shuts off. Clear. Actually, or in some of the ACs, what you'll see, the compressor gets set off, the outdoor unit. When the room temperature again it increases more than 24, again the AC runs. AC is running. So these kind of programmable thermostats we can use. You can install it where you can eliminate this waste energy which is used for heating and cooling without upgrading your HVAC system, without upgrading your heating, ventilation, air conditioning system. Without upgrading that, you can simply install this programmable smart programmable thermostat or smart thermostat. If you use, on an average, you can save 18,000 per year. So programmable thermostats come in different models. Okay, and that can be set to fit your weekly schedule. So additional features of programmable thermostats you can include where when to replace these air filters or in HVAC system problems, which will also improve the efficiency of your heating and cooling system. So ultimately, what will happen is it is not possible that every 15 days you go and check the air filters of this particular HVAC system, heating, ventilation, and air conditioning system. So if you have some kind of smart, what you can say, gadget or some you can say sensors, where automatically it will say you that a time has come to replace your air filters, then that would have been much more better, where you can save the energy. Because if the air filters are not in good condition, the AC will consume more and more energy. Okay. So fifth way where you can conserve electrical energy is, excuse me, to purchase energy efficient appliances. On an average, appliances are also responsible for 13% of total household energy use. So whenever you are purchasing any appliances, electrical appliances, you should also pay attention to two numbers. One is the cost price, the purchase price of that electrical equipment or appliance, and second one is annual operating cost. If I operate that particular electrical equipment for 1 year, how much it is going to cost to me? That you have these two things, which is in the form of numbers. One is your cost of that particular electrical equipment, for how much cost you're purchasing, and second one is what is the operating cost, annual operating cost. That. So although in market you'll see energy efficient appliances, many has come in the market in nowadays, technology as changing day by day. But nowadays we are also seeing that we don't find any much difference. That means star rated ACs, five star, three star, five star we are buying, but we don't find any kind of much. Mainly, you can say 9 to 25% operating costs less will it will be, not more than 25% also. Okay, but still, 25% is not, again, a small, you can say, value. So whenever you are purchasing any energy efficient appliance, you should look for appliances with Energy Star label, which is a guarantee that that particular appliance, if it is higher Energy Star label, that is going to consume very less energy when you are using it or when it is on standby mode. Clear? So these energy savings, they differ based on specific appliance. Okay. For example, you take Energy Star certified washing machine, which consumes 25% less energy and 45% less water than conventional one, which doesn't have any star or less star, 1 star. Clear? Similarly, Energy Star refrigerators, when we compare with less Energy Star refrigerators, 5 star when you compare with 3 star, you'll see electrical consumption will be less. It will vary from brand to brand, from appliance to appliance. So again, next, coming to the next, the sixth way where you can electrical energy can be conserved is reduce your water heating expense. That means we are talking about heaters, water heaters. Okay, this particular, during winter season especially, what is happening is we are using these heaters, and ultimately the best way is simply use very less hot water, or there are thermostats in those water heaters. You can simply turn it down. Or one more way is you can insulate those water heater pipes, or you can say the first 6 feet of the hot pipe and cold pipe, till 6 feet you can insulate it. By that also you can, insulation means the outer pipe I'm talking about. By that way also you can save energy. If you do insulation, you see, if there is no insulation, I'm trying to explain, if there is no insulation, what will happen, that heat energy will escape from that pipe. That means when water, hot water is flowing through a pipe, the pipe gets heated up, and through that heated pipe, heat energy is, there is a loss of heat energy and to the surroundings. So that by applying some kind of what you can say, some radiance, okay, by applying some kind of radiance, what you can do is, by insulating some, insulating those pipes, that particular heat energy loss can be minimized. Yeah, so for example, if you're thinking that by listening this, if you're thinking that let me replace my water heater with a good model, then simply keep two things, two factors in mind. First thing is which type of water heater you want to use, and what is the type of fuel that it is going to use to run that water heater. The two things you should keep in mind. So which type of water heater means what? That means depending upon the size of the family. For example, you'll find the water heaters which doesn't have these tanks or water tanks inside to store water. Clear? But that's a very poor choice, where tankless waters mostly you will find in these hotels. Clear? Where there is no storage of this particular water that is getting heated up with the help of thermostat. It is not getting stored. So in those cases, it's very poor choice, and ultimately what will happen is wastage of water as well as energy is going to take place. So better is efficient water heaters. It can be anywhere between 8% to 300% more energy efficient than if we compare it with the conventional storage water heater. Seventh way to reduce or conserve this electrical energy is install energy efficient windows. Energy efficient windows. Now, these till sixth point, somewhat we all know, and we can do it also. The seventh point, energy efficient windows, to some of you it is little bit a new, or you can say for some people it is okay, but for some people it might be a different word. Clear? So what is this actually we are talking about? That is what, in energy efficient windows. That means, so windows are significant source of energy wastage. Most of us, maybe you might be surprised by hearing this. So ultimately 10 to 25% of this this cost of this particular electricity bill which you're getting, 10 to 25% is extra bill which you're paying, it is due to these windows only. Then you'll ask, sir, how it is possible? So, because to prevent these kind of heat losses through windows, you can replace these windows by single pane windows or double pane products. And this is what I'm talking about. This is single pane. Okay, see, single pane, you see, single pane means you'll find only one glass, this which I'm talking about. This is single pane. and this is a double pane, where double glass. Okay, so the double glass or double glass pane products, you can use it. So if there are reasons which are colder, there you'll find windows with some kind of coatings where you can reduce your heating expenses. And in addition, interior or exterior storm windows also you can use, where you can reduce unnecessary heat loss by 10% to 10%. Then again, sir, what is this storm windows? I am going to show you this. This is a storm window, total seal. You can see here. This kind of windows also you might have seen. These are called as storm windows. Okay. By this also you can save energy, storm windows. Clear? Then comes your in warmer climates, what will happen is heat gain is through windows may be a problem. Clear? When during summer season, what will happen? The heat comes through windows, and due to that also electrical energy gets wasted. Clear? So depending on all these things, better let us use wherever you are living. Energy star windows also you will get nowadays, by which you can save around 2000 to 10000 rupees each year on your bills. So window shades, shutters, screens. So window shades, everybody has seen. What I'm talking about, these are window shades. Clear? Which are also called as this particular word, awnings. So these are also called as awnings. These kind of window shades, by which this particular during summer season, directly due to these shades, hot air or cold air may not enter into the room, by which you can save the energy by using this particular less electrical equipments. Then next is, you can also have an extra layer of insulation between your home and outside temperature. Clear? So that also you can do it. Nowadays you have some kind of paints where if you don't have the top in the roof, what you're doing is you're applying those kind of paints where the room temperature gets decreased, and by virtue of that also you can save energy. The eighth way is upgrading your HVAC system. Clear? So an HVAC system is actually composed of heating. What is HVAC? Heating, ventilation and air conditioning equipment. Clear? So this is called as HVAC system. Okay? So how do we upgrade it? So heating alone is not responsible for more than 40%. Okay? Heating alone is not at all responsible. Clear? For more than 40% of your home energy use. Because most of the homes in northern regions, since we are talking about the northern America side, they are exposed to colder temperatures during the total year. So in those cases, you are using Energy Star gas furnaces, which have different specifications in the northern and southern half of the United States. Clear? The same thing, the Energy Star gas furnaces, Energy Star air conditioners. If you use, ultimately, per year, you can at least save some 12 to 16% of your bills, electricity bills, you can save it. So this is how do you upgrade your HVAC system. Simply by upgrading your HVAC system is you're simply using this particular, all these components or electrical equipments which are highly rated, highly Energy Star rated. Okay. So ninth one is weatherize your home. Weatherizing means sealing the air leaks around your home. Clear? Sealing also, we are doing it in most of our houses, and it's a very great way to reduce your heating and cooling expenses. Clear? Now the most common way where leakages are there is vents, which I'm talking about this particular which cooling system is we are talk I'm not talking about an individual air conditioning. I'm talking about the total house. Okay, in those cases you find these vents and ducts, okay, windows and doors. So to prevent these leaks, what you're doing is you should see that there are no cracks or no openings in between the wall and the windows, between the wall and the doors, clear door frame. To all this, if there are any kind of leakages, simply you can apply this caulk. Sir, what is then again, sir, what is this caulk? Caulk is this. This is what I'm talking about. Clear? So the caulk is actually, you can say, it's a kind of glue where wherever there is a leakage, you are applying this particular cloud. Okay, so this is called as a caulk. Not only this, see, this is in this cases here in this window frames. If there are any kind of leakages, we are using this caulk. Now in windows, I'm showing you. Now here, not only this, you can also apply weather stripping. This mostly we are using in this India. Weather stripping is you might have seen this rubber sheets around the corner. Clear? These are all weather strippings which we are using around the corners of the doors and windows. Clear? In order to what you do, you know, in order to have this particular kind of seal, not to escape this particular cool air and hot air outside during cool air during hot season and the hot air during winter season. Okay, so weather stripping and caulking, they are very simple air sealing techniques, which is a return on investment, we can say, in less than a year. So all these air leakings, which are leakages which you find in your home or mainly in the interior, clear, wherever there are small openings, small leakages, this you can check it with the help of this particular. You can use it by using caulk and weather stripping. You can do it. Last one, important one, is insulating your home. This is the most important thing, the way where you can conserve the energy. So insulation is going to play a very important role in lowering your utility bills through retaining the heat during winter and keeping heat out of your home during the summer. So the recommended, or keeping the heat out of your home during the summer, the recommended level of heat resistance or R value for the insulation, it totally depends where you are living. Suppose in warmer climates, the R value should be much more lower, okay, than for buildings located in colder regions like the northeast of the America. So the level of insulation that you are going to give for your home, it depends upon in which area your house is getting built up. Your walls, your basement, your floors, and every these your attics, clear, and then crawling space, all these things. Attic means this. Please see here. Mostly you'll find I'm talking about the, this is known as this attic hatch. Okay, this is attic. Clear? So mainly these five things: attics, walls, floor, basement, and crawling space. These are the five main areas where you are going to add this, or where you are going to insulate it. So by these 10 ways, you can conserve the energy. Why actually we have talked about, and why we are keeping this conservation of energy in the first place? Because this is very much important, and in the present state, it is very much important and beneficial for many reasons. Clear? Why? Because is you can save money, you can increase your property value, you are also protecting the environment, and by simply using simple techniques of energy saving measures. Clear? And these are all great benefits where you can save energy, and no matter what is your exact motivation for conservation of energy, that is, whether it is in the first place or not, by if you simply take very small steps towards living a more energy conscious lifestyle, then you see simply very small, small tips you have to follow. If you are going to live this energy conscious lifestyle, if you are going to live, you can begin to enjoy all your life and for being this particular energy efficient. Okay. Thank you very much. I hope you have understood this particular topic. Yes. Thank you. Thank you very much.